Hey guys, welcome to my channel, and in today's video we're going to be recreating the dollhouse that comes with the base game in Sims 4. So I've just gone ahead and sized up the dollhouse that we're going to be recreating today, and I want to try get it as exact as possible. We are just going to keep this here just so I can keep referring back to it. So the shell is pretty simple, it's just a rectangle, and the roof is pretty simple too, it just comes straight across, which makes life a lot easier for me. So for the roof, it has the same design as this one, but it looks a lot more pink. So if we can find one that has a bit more of a pinker swatch. I actually think I'm going to go with this one. It's a little bit darker than the actual dollhouse, but I think that might be the best we're going to get. We do also have this little section that comes out at the front. For this, I'm going to just do, I think these match. Have they just twisted round? Or am I going crazy? I think... yeah, they did twist around. I think they twisted around on their own. That was pretty weird. Also going to add this little roof piece on top of here and then have that the same color as the roof we've already got. The actual walls of the house is kind of like a yellow sand color, I guess I'd say. We have these, which kind of look quite similar actually, because they have that white line very similar to in the middle of here. I think I'm going to go with that. We need some steps coming down from the front. I might go for these just sand coloured ones. I think they match pretty well actually. So let's actually do the garden before we do anything else with the house. For the rocks at the front, I think I'm going to add... should we just do that? I think that looks pretty similar. Then we need this little pond here, so we might have to move this back a bit. First of all, let's dig out the floor, and it's kind of like that kind of shape, and then let's fill that with water. I like that. Then we do actually have a big rock over this side and have that there, and then if we come over to this side we have a weird Minecraft looking tree which we're gonna put here, but I don't think we have any square trees in Sims. This one. Or do we actually have a square bush? We actually do have a square bush. I could size that up. We could use this and we could raise this up. Oh no, that's not gonna work. Okay, I'm gonna make this idea work. We could use one of these tree branches. That is perfect. Okay. This is great. I love it. Okay, we'll keep that there. That's kind of in the perfect position already. We have two little bushes up at the front of the house. These ones? Yes. So we'll do two of these up at the front of the house. We do need some other little lily pads and other extras around the pond. Let's add some lily pads and a smaller one on this side. And then I'm going to add some of these. Okay, I added a couple extra around the pond. I know it wasn't in the picture, but I want it to make it look like an actual real pond. And then finally, we just need a little hedge. Is it on both sides? Yeah, two little hedges down each side. Could use these ones, which are a bit more square looking. We have these ones with the flowers on. I think we do have these also. These ones look the most square, so we're gonna go with those. So we'll do that. We'll move this to this side. Try and get them in the same spot. That. Now we need to do the features on the house. So we have these ones. Or I think we do have some smaller ones. These ones. So we're gonna add four of these. They look so small. Do we actually have anything that's bigger? Oh, these are bigger. Let's add these ones actually in white if they have it. Yes, perfect. Okay, we'll add four of these. They look way better. And then for the door, it's just a really basic door. We'll just do this one. And then is there anything else we need on the outside? Oh, we do need this actually, underneath the window, just on one side, weirdly. So I think that one matches pretty well. I might put two. Okay, that's pretty much the outside done. So we have the weird Minecraft looking tree. We have the hedges on each side, the pond and the stones coming out from the front of the house like this. Now let's head to the back of the house, and we need to make all this area open. I'm going to take fences, just any fences, and open it all up. And then we can actually just go ahead and delete all the fences. Okay, I went ahead and deleted all the fences. We need to add these pillars. So I think I'm gonna do the same ones that I did at the front of the house. And then also on this side as well. Now for the flooring, it's just plain wood. So I think we might do the same as what we have at the front here. And cover both floors in that. But let's actually focus on the top floor first. The walls, we have this red, purple and green color going on. But for the red, maybe this. Yeah, I think we're gonna have to go for this one, but let's just do it on one quarter. The middle color was purple, and that's great. We don't have anything purple with stripes down the middle. We could do that, or we could just do this plain purple color, or do we just go for the plain? Okay, let's just go for the plain. For the other side, we have this pastel green color. Let's see what we have. That's pastels. We have this one. We have this, but that looks more like mint to me. We have that one. That one's quite nice, actually. Okay, let's go with that. Then we have randomly this yellow patch of flooring. So let's do that. So after searching to the ends and back of the Sims game, I had to settle on this rug. Because Sims just seems to hate the color yellow or anything associated with the color yellow. So we're gonna have this as the floor. And then we also need a purple rug to go on top of that. And I'm really hoping the purple rug sits on top of the yellow rug. So we're gonna use, I think, this one. No! No, it doesn't. No, why? Okay, back to square one. This rug, goodbye. This rug, you are going here. So the only thing we've really got is this one, which is super bright. Absolutely none of them. We could do this fuzzy thing. I think we might have to go for that. Oh, I'm going for this because I'm sick of looking for yellow floors. Okay, let's do that. Let's move swiftly on. So for furniture, the green side, we have this purple bed. In the middle, we have this singular lamp. And then over here, we have a grey sofa and a tomato. Great interior choices from the Sims 4 team when creating this dollhouse. First of all, we're gonna go for the bed. It's kind of a purpley pink, so I'm gonna filter it by purple and pink. We have this bed, this one. We could do a double. Oh, I think it is actually a double bed. Yeah, it is. Look, it's got two pillows. Okay, let's do a double bed then. But this one matches the solid color and the white pillows. So I think we're gonna go with this one. Then on this side, we just have this really basic lamp. So it's literally just gray. Nothing exciting there. And I mean, this one pretty much matches the description of what we're looking for. Then we have this grey armchair, which we're gonna pop here. So we could do this. We could do this. That one's also a bit more grey. Okay, so I'm gonna go with this chair. I think we might size it up. We also do need to add some stairs. So again, I'm gonna use the same ones that we used outside there. Then we need that tomato. So I had a little search through Debug because I know they have a lot of fruit and veg. And I did find a tomato. So I'm just going to size it up and pop it there by the stairs, which looks pretty much the same as this one does here. And then that's pretty much everything for upstairs. So now let's head downstairs. So for the downstairs, we have orange, blue, and beige. We have a blue flooring for the kitchen. Well, we just have two items in the kitchen and two items in the living room. So for orange, I'm gonna do there. Maybe this one. Yeah, let's do that one. And then for the beige, I'm gonna go for this one. Let's do the kitchen floor in this blue. Let's try and find something that looks similar. This one looks the same color here. I think we might actually do that. But in the kitchen, we just had two items. So I'm gonna go for this one. Let's do the matching cooker. I think they look like pretty similar colors if we compare them. Then in the living room, this one looks kind of similar, but it's just quite big. We could do it in the smaller version. I'm gonna go with this one. This one looks the most similar to me. Let's pop that in the center there. We just have this really simple little desk to finish it off. We could do that. I think I might actually size this one down. We could size this one down. Yeah, let's do this one. So I've sized down that coffee table and that's just gonna go in front. So I think that is everything in the house. Let's have a look. We have the sofa, and is that sofa floating in the air or is that just me? That sofa is fully floating in the air. Okay, let's fix that. That is so random. Why was that doing that? So next, what do we need? We need this outside. So we have this one. Oh, there is another one, I believe. This one, yes. Let's see what swatches we have. We have the light blue one. That looks so, so similar. Perfect. And I think that's everything done, guys. That looks so weirdly similar. Let's just have a little look around, make sure we haven't forgotten anything. I don't think we have forgotten anything, and I think this looks really successful. So this is it from the front. Oh no, what's happened to the wall? Let's just go ahead and fix that just when we thought we were finished. Let's try that again. So from the front, we're looking pretty identical. Then from this side, if we just ignore the trees randomly now growing in the living room, they're looking very, very similar. And I'm really glad with how this build turned out. If you guys enjoyed this build just as much as I did, then don't forget to leave a like, subscribe, and a comment on which room you thought was your favorite. And stay tuned for more of my Sims 4 videos.